This video contains complete extra question answers of the whole chapter. So I hope this will be useful. Do let us know in the comments if anything else is required.
Hello guys, today we are going to do class 6 history chapter 1, what, where, how and when. The question answers we are going to do. What is history? History is the study of past. What did the people live? Where did the people live several hundred thousand years ago? People lived on the banks of River Narmada several hundred thousand years ago. What do we study in history? In history, we study about the lives of hunters, herders, farmers, rulers, merchants, priests, craft persons, artists, musicians, and scientists. Why were the earliest people called skill gatherers? The earliest people were called skill gatherers because they collected roots, fruits, and other forest produce for their food. Name the areas where agriculture developed. The agriculture was developed in the Garo Hills to the northeast and Vindhyas in the central India. Name an important city on the banks of River Ganga. Magda was an important city on the banks of River Ganga. Name the areas where men and women first began to grow crops. The areas where men and women first began to grow crops were the Suleiman and Kirthar Hills to the northwest. Where did people live 100,000 years ago? What work did they do? People lived on the banks of River Narmada 100,000 years ago. The people were skill gatherers and collected roots, fruits, and other forest produce for their food. They also hunted animals. What can we know about the past? There are several things we can find out about the past. What people ate, the kinds of clothes they wore, the houses in which they lived in. We can find out about the lives of hunters, herders, farmers, rulers, merchants, priests, craft persons, artists, etc. We can also find out about the games children played, the stories they heard, the plays they saw, and the songs they sang. Why did people travel in olden days? Men and women moved in search of livelihood. Second, to escape from natural disasters like floods or droughts. Sometimes men marched in armies conquering other lands. Merchants traveled with caravans or ships carrying valuable goods from place to place. Religious teachers walked from village to village, town to town, stopping to offer instructions and advice on the way. What was the impact or result of the movement of people from one part of the subcontinent to another? It led to the sharing of ideas between people. These movements of people enriched our culture. People share new ways of carving stones, composing music, and even cooking food. What is the role of archaeologists? They study about the remains of buildings made up of stones or bricks, paintings, and sculptures. They explore and excavate to find tools, weapons, pots, and ornaments. They study the coins made of stones, bones, and baked clay and metals. They find out what people ate in the past. They look for bones of birds, animals, and fish. What were the difficulties faced by the people who came and settled in the subcontinent? Hills, mountains, and seas formed natural barriers. They had to scale the mountains, cross the seas and rivers. What is archaeology? It is the branch of knowledge that studies the remains of the past and gathers information. What are manuscripts? Manuscripts are the records of the past written by hand on palm leaves or on the back of the birch tree. Where are manuscripts found? They are found in temples and monasteries. Why are manuscripts Why are manuscripts not durable? They are eaten by insects, some were destroyed. What kind of subject did manuscripts deal with? Religious beliefs and practices, the lives of kings, medicine and science, epics, poems and plays. Name the languages in which manuscripts were written. Prakrit, Sanskrit and Tamil. What are inscriptions? Inscriptions are the records of past written on a hard surface such as stones or metals. What are the sources that tell us about the past? Manuscripts, inscriptions and archaeology. What is the full form of BC, CE, BCE and AD? Full form are as follows. BC means before Christ, CE is common era, BCE is before common era and AD is Anno Domini. Okay, so now we have finished with the revision of question answers and now we will do a small fill in the blanks means a type of revision test. People lived on the banks of river Narmada several hundred thousand years ago. Name the large kingdom to the south of river Ganga. Magadha was the large kingdom to the south of river Ganga. About 4700 years ago, earlier cities developed on the banks of river Dash. So it will not be Ganga, it will be Indus. Because cities developed 2500 years ago on the banks of river Ganga and its tributaries, but not on Indus. So this is wrong. Name two areas where women and men first began to grow crops. Suleiman and Kirthar Hills. Now, handwritten records of the past written on palm leaf are known as Dash. They are manuscripts. The study of the remains of the past is known as Dash.
Archaeology.
Dash were records written on hard surface. Inscriptions. Now, Dash are scholars who study the past. Scholars are the historians, not archaeologists. So this is the correct answer. Manuscripts and inscriptions are the sources to study the past. Name two languages in which manuscripts were written, Sanskrit and Tamil. Or you can write Prakrit also. You can choose any two, Sanskrit, Tamil or Prakrit. That's your wish. Okay, so now we have finished with the question answers of the chapter and the fill in the blanks. And now we are going to do a short assignment. These answers we have revised only. These were written in the copy only. I have made you revise. Now let's do true or false. Latin word manu means hand. It is true. Manuscripts were written on the banana leaf. It is false. They were written on the palm leaf or on the bark of the birch tree. Birch tree is found in Himalayas. It is true. Now, Anno Domini means the year of Lord. False. Sorry, this first one will be true. It is not false. Anno Domini means the year of Lord. It is true. About 5,000 years ago, cities developed on the banks of the Ganga. It is false because 2500 years ago, cities were developed on the banks of river Ganga. Branch of knowledge that examines the physical remains of the past and gathers evidence is called archaeology. It is true. Kings got their orders inscribed so that people could see, read and obey them. It is true. Now match the following. So Narmada Valley. We will match Narmada Valley with hunting and gathering. Because people did hunting and gathering there. Magadha. Magadha is the first big kingdom. Where the first big kingdom was made. Garo Hills are early agriculture. The agriculture was developed over here. Indus and its tributaries. Cities about... Sorry, I left this. Ganga Valley is cities about 2500 years ago. Mean cities developed on the banks of river Ganga 2500 years ago. Indus and its tributaries is the first cities. The first cities. The cities were developed over here or flourished over here. BC, full form is before Christ. Manuscripts are eaten by insects. Now, what kind of subjects did the manuscripts deal with? The lives of kings, medicines and science, epics, poems and plays, religious beliefs and practices. These were the subjects with which manuscripts deal with. Give any one example why people travelled in olden days. They travelled in search of livelihood. This is the answer. Or you can write any which you are knowing. Like they moved in to escape from natural disasters like floods or droughts or men marched in armies conquering other lands. You can write any of these. Now, what animals did the people rear about 8,000 years ago? They rear sheep, goats and cattle. What were the objects found by archaeologists made up of? The objects found by archaeologists were made up of stones, bricks, bones, metal, baked clay, coins. Coins were made of stones, bricks, bones, baked clay and metal. Okay, so now we have done all the revision of this chapter. I'll be meeting you soon with the extra questions from the chapter. This was the assignment. Thank you. Guys, today we are going to do chapter 1 of history of class 6th. That is what, where, how and when. So let's start. Where did earliest people live? On the banks of river Narmada. What did earliest people do? They were skilled gatherers and hunters. Why are earliest people called skilled gatherers? Because they used to gather their food. Did earliest people have knowledge about plant wealth? Explain. Yes, they had such knowledge as they used to collect roots, fruits and other forest produce from surrounding forests. Now we are on page 2. When was early agriculture developed? What was grown at that time? Answer is 18,000 years ago, early agriculture was developed and wheat and barley was grown. Now, what was early agriculture developed? Where was early agriculture developed and when? In Suleiman and Kirthar Hills about 8,000 years ago. Direction of Suleiman and Kirthar Hills is northwest. Facts for the periods about 8,000 years ago. Men and women began to grow crops like wheat and barley. People began to rear animals like sheep, goat and cattle. People lived in villages. Next question. Direction of Garo Hills is northeast. Direction of Vindhyas is central India. Page 3. Where was agriculture developed? Garo Hills to the northeast and Vindhyas in central India. Where was the rice first grown? To the north of the Vindhyas. What are tributaries? They are small rivers that flow into a larger river. Where were earliest cities flourished? On the banks of river Indus and its tributaries. When were earliest cities flourished about? Earliest cities flourished? They were flourished about 4700 years ago. Facts about the period. 2500 years ago. Cities developed on the banks of Ganga and its tributaries. Iranians and Greeks came through northwest. This point is on page number 14. This point is on just a second. This is going to run page number. Name a tributary of Ganga. Is Sun. Write facts about Magda. It is an area to the south of the Ganga. It is an area to the south of Ganga. It is currently in the state of Bihar. A large kingdom was first developed here. Its rulers were very powerful. Was it easy or difficult for people to travel across subcontinent? It was difficult because of natural frontiers including hills, seas and mountains, but not impossible. Why religious teachers used to travel to offer their instructions and advice? How merchants used to travel with caravans or ships carrying valuable goods from place to place? Name the countries in South Asia. There are 10 countries, India, Bangladesh, Pakistan, Nepal, Bhutan, Sri Lanka, Afghanistan, China, Myanmar and Iran. So, I have written these words just because I learn in this way. I always take the first letter of the country and always learn like this. Like, I from India from I, B for Bangladesh, B for Pakistan, N for Nepal, B for Bhutan and so on. So, I usually like it to do like this, IBP, NBS, ACMI. So I think of the shortcuts that I can remember. And these are on the page number 3 of the book here. So first I had given the 6 countries that are India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Nepal, Bhutan and Sri Lanka. So it is here, and the rest four neighboring countries are separated. So that's why I've written like this. If you want, you can learn. Why is South Asia called subcontinent? Because although it is smaller than a continent, but it is very large and is separated from the rest of Asia by seas, hills and mountains. What are the names given or used for our country? India and Bharata. How our country got these two names? So first we'll describe how India, we got the name of our country. Our country is known as India, and this has come from the word Indus, which means Sindhu in Sanskrit. About 2500 years ago, Iranians and Greeks came through northwest and they were familiar with the Indus and called it Hindos or Indos, and called the land to the east of the river Indus as India. Second is, we'll describe Bharat. There was a group of people who lived in northwest, which was called mentioned as Bharata in Rigveda. Later, this name was used for our country. Now, Rigveda is composed in Sanskrit, means it is written in Sanskrit. Name the earliest composition of Sanskrit language. It was Rigveda. Sorry, this is a joint word and this V will be small. I'll write it again. Rig Veda. Yeah. When was Rig Veda composed? About 3500 years ago. Where were birch trees found in they were found in Himalayas. Sources of past. How can we know about past? There are two categories. First is literary sources, that are manuscripts and inscriptions. Second is archaeological sources, remains of the buildings, pots, pans, weapons, etc. So these are not given in the book, but a question can come that describe the sources of past in two categories. So you can write literary sources and archaeological sources. And then you can tell that these are literary sources are divided into two, that are manuscripts and inscriptions, and archaeological sources is archaeology. So as we all know that there are three sources of past, that are manuscript, inscriptions and archaeology. So I have described it like this. Describe about origin of word manuscript. Word manu comes from Latin origin. Word me, which means hand. Define Prakrit. Now we are on page 5. It is language used by ordinary people. Where are inscriptions written on hard surfaces like stone or metal? What were the contents of inscriptions? Orders of kings, recordings by men and women about what they did, records of victories of kings in battle. Who are archaeologists? People who study the objects and things made and used in past. Define script. The letters or signs used to write something is called script. Define language. When we read what is written or when we speak, it is called language. Now we are on page number 6. In which form burnt wood or burnt seeds of grain survive? In a charred form they survive. Define historians. They are the scholars who study the past. True or false? Learn about the past is adventurous. It is true. Historians and archaeologists are like dash who use historical sources as dash. So historians and archaeologists are like detectives who use their sources as clues. Page number 7. How most people of Andaman Islands get their food by fishing, hunting, collecting forest produce. What helps us to find out records of past? Archaeology helps us. How are the years counted from the date assigned to the birth of Jesus? Who was Jesus Christ, founder of Christianity? Now we are on page 8. Name the terms used for dates BC or BCE, AD or CE. So I want to tell you the full form of these two, that is BC is before Christ and BCE is before Common Era. AD is Anno Domini and CE is Common Era. Why are these terms used? Because Christian era is now used in most countries of the world. When was this form of dating began to be used in India? From about 200 years ago. BP means before, present, and Anno Domini is Latin word. Define decipherment. It is process by which scholars understand what has been inscribed on inscriptions. And this is written over here on the page 8 of your history books in this box, decipherment. So this is its definition. Thank you. Today we have, so I'm back with the history chapter 1. This is the part 3. Now we are...
And it's the last part.
Yeah, it is the last.
Extra question and answers.
Yeah, so we revise from page 6. Why is the word past used in plural form in the title of history book? Because different groups of people had different past. In this book, which year is used as starting point to calculate time period? Year 2000. Study of past is called history. Past period for which we have records is called historical period. Past period for which no records are available is called prehistoric period. Study of remains of past is called archaeology. Signs or symbols to write something is called script. Important time periods to be remembered. About 8,000 years ago, early agriculture, wheat and barley grown. About 4700 years ago, first cities developed on Indus and its tributaries. About 3500 years ago, Rigveda composed. About 2500 years ago, cities developed on Ganga and its tributaries. Plus, Iranians and Greeks came through Northwest. 2000 AD or CE means 2000 Anno Domini or Common Era is present age. True or false? History is an adventure. It is journey across time and space. It is true. History will help you to understand how this present evolved. It will tell you about the past of the present. True. 2000 BC means 2000 years before the birth of Jesus Christ. 2005 AD means 2005 years after the birth of Jesus Christ. Script of Hindi is Devanagari. Script of Punjabi is Gurmukhi. How ancient coins were different from today's coins? Ancient coins were made of stones, baked clay and bones, but now coins are not made with this material. Crops grown 2000 years ago are wheat and barley. 8000. I said that only.
You said 2000.
No. Animals reared by early people were sheep, goat and cattle. Area to south of Ganga is Magadha. Why was Magadha famous? It was the large kingdom and its rulers were powerful. Script consists of letters and signs. Where is Rosetta town in Egypt? Where is Rosetta town located? It is a town in north coast of Egypt. What was found in Rosetta? Answer is an inscribed stone. How many and what languages and scripts were used on inscribed stone found in Rosetta? Three languages and scripts were inscribed: Greek and two forms of Egyptian. What are the occupation of people and Andaman Islands? Fishing, hunting, collecting forest produce. What is cartouche? Scholars who could read cartouche. Scholars who could read Greek figured out the names of kings and queens were enclosed in a little frame called cartouche. Archaeologists look for bones of animals, birds and fish. Why do archaeologists look for bones? To find out eating habits of people in the past. Where is Kandahar now? It is in Afghanistan. What was found in Kandahar? An inscription about orders of ruler Ashoka. What is the best example of understanding history? Through decipherment. The history of Egypt. Meaning of Indus in Sanskrit is Sindhu. So now we have completed the chapter 1 of the history books NCERT. Thank you for watching the video. Bye.